starting with the great name of Almighty Allah, who is the most gracious and most beneficent.
Shows that I will show you in later. Next slides. Now the problem on the concentration of the sediment particles, bed load measurements, and by Mayer-Peter-Muller equation and also by the Einstein equation. Let's discuss that. Okay, the first problem statement, I hope it's visible to you all. A wide channel 4 meter deep consists of uniform grains of 0.4 millimeter. The fall velocity of the grains in the silt still water is 0.04 meter per second. Determine the concentration of the load at 1 meter above the bed. If the concentration of the sediment particle at 0.4 meter above the bed is 400 parts per million, take specific gravity of particle as 2.67, L slope is the 1 in 4,444. Then we have the representative roughness of the side of the bed, that is von Kármán's constant is given 2.0 millimeter. Let's solve it. So collecting the data, that is the depth of the channel we have given 4 meter. Slope is 1 by 4,444. Grain size is 0.4 millimeter. Fall velocity, sometimes we are representing it with W. In some books, it is represented with the V. And Y is the depth at which we have to find the unknown concentration C. CA is the reference depth at which the concentration is given, that is CA, and G is the specific gravity. Okay, so that's the formula. C upon CA is equals to D minus Y into A upon D minus A time raised to power Z. So here Z is equals to W upon KU star. So this, the shear velocity is the ratio of top knot to the rho. So Z is equals to W upon K under root tau naught upon rho, where tau naught is equals to gamma W R dash S. This is again the substitution for the shear stress. That shear stress is equals to gamma W R dash S that we have substituted for the tau naught, and then we have got this formula where the R dash is for unrippled, R is for rippled, N dash is for unrippled, N is for rippled, and U dash will become this. Then how it is becoming, let me to explain it on the next page. Now earlier it was shear velocity was equals to the this gamma W R dash, but now we have used the relationship between the unit unit weight of the water with this mass density, means the relationship between the weight density to the mass density. This is which we have substituted here, and from which it have become like this. We have got the gamma WG, and this is how we have substituted that the mass density is the ratio of mass to volume. Mass is equals to rho V. Then gamma will become, as we know that the weight density is equals to weight per unit volume, and weight is equals to mass into gravity. And in the we have substituted M from the above formula of the mass density, that is M is equals to rho W. After substituting this, we have got this relationship, that is the gamma is equal to rho g that we have substituted here, and rho w cancel out. Then we have got g r dash s. So we have the 9.81 r dash value is unknown to us, that we will find from this relationship. By using this relationship, we will find this, but here there is a condition that the in the question it was mentioned that this is the wide channel because of which we know, I have told you that the for wide channel we say R is equals to the D, mean depth is equals to the D. Now instead of R we are using it, replacing it with D, and then again now we have two unknowns, ratio is not known to us, that is n dash to n. So n dash is equals to d power d by 6 by 24 divided by von Kurzmann's constant to the 24 by 6. So by dividing these two values and simplifying this and putting these value, that is the d in the formula, let me show you. D is the 4 meter, no wait, grain size is the 0.4 millimeter and k is the 2 millimeter. So these two values we have substituted in the rugosity coefficients here, n dash and n, and then we have got this ratio. Now we will find the r dash. Substituting this ratio value here, we will get, and the d value, we will get the r dash. Now u star, again we have got the r dash value and substituting 9.81 this and slope, again we will get the shear velocity. Now we will calculate this constant, where that is the ratio of the fall velocity to the von Kurzmann constant times the shear velocity. So fall velocity is also given in the question that we have seen, that the fall velocity is 0.04 millimeter. U dash shear velocity we have already calculated, and von Kurzmann constant is 2.0 millimeter. So here we have substituted these values. Then we have got that Z is equals to 1.3. Now CA is the concentration in terms of the parts per million, but we want it into the kilogram per meter cube. So the relationship or the conversion unit is that one parts per million is equals to 1000 kilogram per meter cube. But again we find per width, concentration per width, that's why we tries to move for the concentration per meter. And for doing that, we will divide meter here, and after dividing it will become 440 × 10⁻³ kilogram per meter square. Now we have got this value d minus y a upon, these are also known, and z value we have found 1.3. Now this is the concentration, unknown concentration. Till here we have found the unknown concentration of this suspended particles. Now the next problem is on the Mayer, Peter and Mueller equation and Einstein equation for the same data. Now in the above problem, determine the quantity of the bed load moved by the channel applying the Mayer, Peter and Mueller equation. And secondly, the Einstein's method. So first, for the first method, this formula is used. GS is equals to 47 tau naught. Let me switch to the next slide. Okay, now in that formula, what is tau b now? That's the product of gamma d into s. Now what these are? If you see in this formula, depth of the channel is the d, that is 4 meter. Slope we have 1 upon 4. 4444, and gamma w is the wet density of the water, that is 1000. So tau b is, we will multiply these three and we will get the tau b. Now the critical shear stress will be calculated by this formula, 0.047 gamma minus gamma w by d by. Now here gamma, we don't know the value of the gamma, that's why we tries to move the this relationship, that is the specific gravity is the ratio of the unit density of the unknown to the density of the water. From here we will substitute the gamma value as the density time specific gravity times the weight density of the water. Here we have placed it in the place of the gamma, and then have taken out common gamma w and have and we have also given the g value in the problem. In this problem, that g is 2.67. Okay, so by substituting g 2.67, gamma w we know 1000, and grain dia we know 0.4 × 10⁻³. That was in millimeter. We have converted into the meter, and now we have got the tau shear as the 0.0314 kilogram per meter square. Ratio we have already calculated. Now substituting these three values into this formula, we will get the bed load by the mu by this equation in the kilogram per meter per hour. We will simply substitute 0.4700 times 0.9 tau b, and this ratio we have got 0.764. In the previous steps, while we were finding the concentration, we found that this ratio, and tau shear stress is 0.0314. This is the bed load in terms of kilogram per meter per hour. That's the answer. Now, second equation. For uniform soil, we know this condition was there. Basically, formula is this. GS is equals to gamma G, phi gamma, phi G gamma W under root G minus 1 and G D cube. And finding, and these two are constant, phi and psi. Psi value we have relative psi value and psi value. These will be equal, and its formula is g minus 1 d minus r dash into s. For, and this was, these r dash value we have already calculated previously in the formula from the relationship. S we know, and d is the grain diameter, g is a specific gravity. From here we have got the psi value, that is 1.11. now we will use the Einstein's curve that is here. Now, if you see that one point, this up to here, the psi value is 1. Somewhere here will be 1.1. And if we will try to intersect this curve that is move, that you can see, this is the relationship of the curve between the these two constants, that is psi and phi. So if we will intersect this psi value with this curve, we will somehow reach here. So from 1 to here, I think that will be 4. Means just visually analyze that how much it can be, that is 4. Because from 1 to 10, this is the fraction, and then division up to here, I think that would be 4. So coming to the problem, then we will get this as the phi is equals to 4. So now G, substituting the phi value, G we know the specific gravity, unit weight of the water we know that T, that is 10⁻³, specific gravity again we know, and the gravity, acceleration due to gravity 9.81, grain dia is the again 0.4 into, but here we are also multiplying the 3600. Why? Because we want it per hour. We want it per hour. Okay, now moving. So that's the answer basically after solving this, that is the bed load from the Einstein equation. So here the problems ends. Now moving towards the next portion.